A young girl finds herself transported to the theme park created in her imagination. Mike Scott from NOLA.com, the Times-Picayune is here. So basically, she's Walt Disney.
She's a little kid. Sort of, kind of. I hadn't thought about that.
I mean, that sounds like a great movie, but what do you think?
A little bit high concept, kind of got that fantastical plot behind it. And I'll tell you what, it's not going to win the box office this week. This is the big movie of the week. Captain Marvel's going to hold over, which came out last week. This will probably do best among the new releases. And I'll tell you, the hits on this one are pretty universal. That is as nice as it looks and as cool of an idea as it sounds like, it just doesn't live up to that wonder in the title. It's sort of a pedestrian story. Little kids will probably enjoy it. But I'll tell you what, here's a pro tip, is if you want to take the family to go see something, we talked last week a little bit about the Zeitgeist Theater's new family series that they have every day at 2. They have a great one this week called The Big Bad Fox and Other Tales. It's kind of a classic style animated film. I think that would be your better pick if you really want to take the family out to go see it.
All right, because this sounds like a great story.
Everything I've read on it so far, I haven't seen it yet, everything I've read on it is that it's just sort of a shrug.
Oh, well. Captive State is a kind of a so-so science fiction thing with John Goodman, you think?
John Goodman, indeed. This is a sci-fi, dystopian sci-fi thriller set 10 years after aliens have invaded and colonized Earth, and human beings are relegated to being sort of an oppressed minority. And human collaborators with the aliens help keep the resistance in check, and this is a story about the resistance. John Goodman is in it. He plays one of those collaborators, a Chicago cop, who's trying to hunt out the resistance fighters. And there's some good ideas going on here and some really interesting thoughts and some subtext going on. But my problem was there wasn't enough character development to really make me care a whole lot about these characters. So while it's got some things going for it, it really lacked a soul to pull me in.
And they don't give him the opportunity to lift the movie as some actors
can? Well, I'll tell you what, he is a high point in the movie, but I don't know that the movie makes it that far.
All right, this is the title of the week, meaning I love the movie title.
I think of the year.
Is The Man Who Killed Hitler and Then Bigfoot.
Right.
Okay.
Which is also the summary of the movie. Right. It's a story about a World War II vet who is haunted by his time from the war, and who the government then recruits to hunt and kill Bigfoot. This one, again, the big question is, does it live up to that title? And of course it can't. That's just such a great title. It's got Sam Elliott in it, which is a plus. He's always good in everything he does. He plays the lead role. But in this one, I think the thing, my biggest problem with it was it didn't have any kind of sense of humor. It's a very melancholy movie, a very brooding movie. And so at one point, he tells characters about his time in the service. It's not the comic book that you want it to be. And I felt that way about this movie.
And yet they all look visually interesting, all of them.
They all have something to go for, something to recommend them, but they just don't quite make it, over that fully recommend.
Okay, Mike Scott, who normally likes movies, but apparently not this week.
So I've had a bad week, John.
Thanks, Mike. Yeah, and you took it out on Hollywood.
That's right.
All right, thanks. Coming